July 5th, 2021, Hebrews 10, 19-39. God's Word of Faith. Introduction, Hebrews 10, 19-39. The Lord's followers are encouraged to keep their hearts pure and their consciences free from evil as they help each other prepare for the day when the Lord will return. Today's scripture, Hebrews 10:22, let us come near to God with a sincere heart and a sure faith, with hearts that have been purified from a guilty conscience and with bodies washed with clean water. Today's reading, let us come near to God. 19, we have, then, my friends, complete freedom to go into the most holy place by means of the death of Jesus. 20, he opened for us a new way, a living way, through the curtain, that is, through his own body. 21, we have a great priest in charge of the house of God. 22, so let us come near to God with a sincere heart and a sure faith, with hearts that have been purified from a guilty conscience, and with bodies washed with clean water. 23, let us hold on firmly to the hope we profess, because we can trust God to keep his promise. 24, let us be concerned for one another, to help one another, to show love and to do good. 25, let us not give up the habit of meeting together, as some are doing. Instead, let us encourage one another all the more, since you see that the day of the Lord is coming nearer. 26, for there is no longer any sacrifice that will take away sins if we purposely go on sinning after the truth has been made known to us. 27. Instead, all that is left is to wait in fear for the coming judgment and the fierce fire which will destroy those who oppose God. 28. Anyone who disobeys the law of Moses is put to death without any mercy when judged guilty from the evidence of two or more witnesses. 29. What, then, of those who despise the Son of God, who treat as a cheap thing the blood of God's covenant which purified them from sin, who insult the Spirit of grace? Just think how much worse is the punishment they will deserve. 30. For we know who said, I will take revenge, I will repay, and who also said, the Lord will judge his people. 31. It is a terrifying thing to fall into the hands of the living God. 32. Remember how it was with you in the past. In those days after God's light had shone on you, you suffered many things, yet were not defeated by the struggle. 33, you were at times publicly insulted and mistreated, and at other times you were ready to join those who were being treated in this way. 34, you shared the sufferings of prisoners, and when all your belongings were seized, you endured your loss gladly, because you knew that you still possessed something much better, which would last forever. 35, do not lose your courage, then, because it brings with it a great reward. 36, you need to be patient in order to do the will of God and receive what he promises. 37. For, as the scripture says, just a little while longer, and he who is coming will come. He will not delay. 38. My righteous people, however, will believe and live. But if any of them turns back, I will not be pleased with them. 39. We are not people who turn back and are lost. Instead, we have faith and are saved. Reflect according to verse 19, we have complete freedom to go into the most holy place by means of the death of Jesus. What does this freedom mean to you? Reread verses 24 and 25. In what ways do these verses describe a community of faith? Reread verse 39. Is this a promise you can claim? Let's pray. Lord God, how thankful I am that I have the freedom to come to you at any time. The perfect sacrifice of your Son, Jesus, who is obedient to your will, has opened a new and living way for me to enter into your presence and rest in your love. Amen. Tomorrow's reading, Hebrews 11:1-21, the great faith of God's people is described.